Hi there, boys and girls. Brucey here, and I'm just going to do a quick review of the Mooa Wata. I was looking for a replacement for my big wah, which I broke. I have a real habit of getting through wahs, and I've liked the idea of some of the MIDI pedals. And to be honest, in later years, particularly in the last year or so, I've kind of moved away a bit from using wah, but it's nice to have one there. So it seems a shame when going to gigs you're carrying around a massive heavy pedal when you don't really use it that much, but you want it in the spare of the moment should you want to go on and get your wah on. So the small pedals really appealed to me. So I've taken a look at the Jim Domlar, and it seemed quite a lot for what it was. So the Mooa isn't that expensive, so I plumped in for that. And this is how it sounds. Now, the thing that concerns me, as you can hear in this audio example here, is it's a great pedal. It sounds pretty great, and it's enough wah for what I need. It does covers all the bases that I really want to use it for. It's a great size. It fits really well on the pedal board. It's surprisingly weighty as well for what it was, but then I guess it's got to withstand someone like me standing on it. The thing that I have a slight issue with is the clicking sound when you're clicking on and off. Sometimes you get it spot on and it doesn't click, but there is an engagement as that pressure sensitive pad is engaged. Now, I've always had problems trying to, you know, you're pressing the toe grip down and you're at that slightly strange angle where you're trying to press a switch which is in a vertical angle, almost a horizontal angle, and trying to get it down. So you end up pressing on top of the wah to engage the wah. It would always be lovely to have a wah which auto engages itself. Now, there are quite a few wahs out there already who use different methods of engaging the wah, but primarily if you're using a Jim Dunlop or a Vox wah, you've got that switch. So Mooa are taking the approach of using the pressure sensitivity, which is the pad at the bottom. When you put your foot on it, it engages the wah. And as you can hear from some of these audio examples, I have had a few problems with that clicking on and off, and it really can make a loud clicking sound, particularly if you've got a lot of distortion on, which I guess in a gigging situation isn't really important because it's momentarily and you don't notice it. It's probably a little bit harder when you're recording and trying to engage that wah and you're getting a clicking sound. For me, I can live with it because, as I said, I'm using this primarily live and it works well for what I want to do. I'm practicing at getting better at hitting that pressure pad square on so it doesn't click as much and I don't slide off. That was the other thing as well, which you can hear here. If you slide your foot around a little bit and you vary the pressure because you're pushing down somewhat and the heel of your foot comes up, sometimes you'll auto unengage the wah and it can click off. So it can be a little bit jumpy, but I think it just requires practice. I guess something we don't tend to do with many pedals. But all in all, I think the Mooa Wata is a great little substitute wah. If you don't wah a lot, if you just want something that will take up a minimum amount of space on your pedal board, that you can use in emergencies and will fill in that wire gap. I think it's certainly worth checking out. I'm very keen to check out the Dunlop wire now, which I know has the click engagement. And I have played with one, but only briefly on a friend's pedal board. I thought it sounded great, and it was easier to press down the switch because the pedal was smaller, so you're not putting all of that weight on the top of your pedal board. As someone who wires a lot, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts and opinions, but I think Mura have made a really good pedal here. I don't know how anyone would be able to get around the technical problem of that pressure engaging the switch and causing it to go on or, particularly if your foot comes up and down, you put a little bit less pressure on for a moment and you've clicked out of wire and you click back in again. It takes some practice, as I said, but all in all, a great product, and I'm keeping it and it's sticking on my pedal board. Hi there, boys and girls, Brucey here. Just wanted to say a massive thank you for checking out my channel. Please do subscribe if you like what you see here. Please do fire away any questions you might have. More than happy to answer them. And if you are in the mood, please do check out my guitar creativity book, which has a whole wealth of information on ways that you can be creative and develop your technique and develop your playing in new and interesting ways. Catch you later.